On page 13, the rites of the Seder are now concluded in accordance with ancient precepts and custom. With the same earnestness that we have prepared for it, may we live our lives throughout the year. Quite appropriately, the Haggadah ends on a note of triumph. Truth, justice, and loving kindness are the enemies of slavery, tyranny, and oppression. The weak may be overcome by the strong, but only for a while, for there are always new emerging forces that crush the seemingly invincible forces prevailing for the moment. Reverend Lee, will you lead us in the interfaith prayer for immigrants?
God of the journey, God of the traveler. We pray for those who seek to make a home in this country may find us welcoming and willing to help them find a path toward citizenship.
We pray for our
pray for those who fan the flames of fear and discrimination against the undocumented. May be touched with your divine love and compassion.
We pray that our holy times and seasons and your restore your best of all times and inspire.
The arc of history does bend toward justice.
We are bending today, together, right now. Amen.
On page 14, together we read, this is the power of Passover. This is the lesson of history. This is the story of freedom. Next year in freedom. And before we sing our final song together, a song that we all know and what an appropriate day, April 4th, to be singing this song, I want to explain to you why you have the egg on your Seder plate. The egg is a symbol of spring. It's a symbol of birth and renewal. There's something that you want to say, Lisa?
Good morning, everyone. If you are, we're all like me, you are filled with a lot of emotion, a lot of happiness to be in a space with people that will share their stories, their personal stories with us. And as we talk about new life and new birth, I am just moved to share with my ICWJ family that I am going to be a mommy. Yeah. And I'm so grateful to share that news with my extended family. And so I am due October 10th of this year.
Okay, one little thing.
As Rabbi Lori explained earlier, when we were starting to talk about Diane, and she went through all the things that we were grateful for this morning, and Diane really is a spur to be grateful for whatever we have around us. But I don't think you can end with that. And so when I rewrote it, and I've rewritten the Haggadah several times, I wrote the ending was, Dayenu would have been enough, but it isn't enough. Until everyone, everywhere, is truly free, we don't have Dayenu.
Amen. So as we stand up to sing, as we're going to stand up to sing, I would like to invite Reverend Lee Hill to lead us in singing We Shall Overcome. Maybe we can learn a little, but we don't have to. And I just also want to thank all of our ICWJ staff and volunteers for supporting this beautiful Seder, all the work they did to make this morning happen.
We shall